Next time you have to.
What's your violation? You're not supposed to be cutting and prepping melons. You're not allowed to sell melons or any part of the melon family. Right? And also you're not supposed to be cutting at the sidewalk. It has to be when you're outside. It's already been prepackaged. Okay? Everything has to be done in the commissary. Na komisaryo, okay?
What are you doing?
Why we're taking them.
Okay,
so firma, nombre and a firma.
Okay, got it.
Okay. We have no more, okay? No more today, okay? Because okay. We catch you again today. Automatic cerrado.
It's all done.
Have the melons. Remember, you see a fruit cart at Santa Monica Pier? Yeah, inside? Uh-huh. They have a refrigeration, they have a three compartment sink, they have a hand washing, they have hot water. That's the only time, because the watermelon, if you remember, I think 8 years ago or a few years ago, there was a salmonella outbreak. One of the culprits is the watermelon. For this kind of cart, no melons.
Education, because you don't know.
When you got the permit,
you were told. Okay.
And the
hotel, they have no Spanish. There's Roberto who speaks Spanish, and that time there's a Rosemary who speaks Spanish.
The day I was there, nobody.
Okay. But do you speak good English?
But not really. I don't know what they say. Some parts I understand, but not.
But you remember, you brought the package, the label. Even in the report, there's no cutting melons, watermelon, honeydew.
But Michael, you know, you guys checked the file, and I never get it. Because I always made, but the Santa Monica said they passed the SB 72, that we can cut it. And you say, no, right now, it's too January.
You can't still cut it. You can't assemble, as I explained to you.
And cut it, you promise.
Come.
Yeah, but I see that the law is basically something. They say they passed.
But effective
January, that's January 1st.
It passed. Effective January.
And then you have to wait for it?
No.
Wait for that one? Because there are some guidelines on what is SB 972.
Allowed and what is not allowed.
What is allowed and what's
what
not allowed.
What are the changes? Yeah. Okay.
So you don't assume anything unless you see the whole thing. And then if you have questions, there's a number that you could call to, for example, hey, I'm confused on this one. What really does it mean? Because I'm confused. So they're going to answer everything. And then if you request for a Spanish speaker, ask them, please provide a Spanish speaker. Okay?
And I'm sure the brochures will be bilingual.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like the street vending.
The street vending is bilingual. It's English and Spanish. No, this one is in English. Because that one is, I'm telling you, no, this one is because you're operating beyond. No, that's. No, you have to call. Just call. Call on Tuesday between 10 to 1 o'clock. And then tell them you've been cited because I'm operating beyond the scope. I'll be there on Tuesday. Just ask for my Corona. Corona. Okay. I'm Corona. Yeah. And that's that number. Okay. Okay. Yeah, I'm going to explain to you why. Oh, well, it's going to be my chief who's going to talk to you. And then if we request for a Spanish speaker, we are going to provide. Robert is there. And then there's also another person. Her name is Gloria. She can translate everything in Spanish so that everything's clear to you.
Gloria?
It's the second time. No, when comes the third, I will close them. But if you see him again today,
I'm going to go to the next one.